Hello everybody, this is Kyrix with another edition of This Week in Kyrix. Today is Wednesday, April 29th, and I am so happy to say that, because that means that Saturday is the day that food gets to happen. Yay, food. Also, I'm underground. I could have sworn I was... Oh, okay. But I could have sworn I was on the surface. I am on the surface. I decided to play. What am I doing? Gold? Iron? Gold. That's right, it is cold. Anyway, Well, it's kind of an eyesore, but here we go. This'll hurt me at least a little bit. Where's my shit, where's my pylon? My pillar? My thing that tells me where I live? Oh, that's right, I'm doing this wrong, derp. Well, isn't that a hell of a thing? I'm gonna need a new one of those. Yoink! It's metal! Oh dear, here we go. I do so hate using cobblestone for anything, really. It's all oogly and such. Stupidly high in the air. I wonder if I can see my project from here, can I? I can! Wow, it's visible from space! Go figure. So much for the pylon, I can't see that from here, but I can see that thing. Okay, this is either going to be very good or very bad. There we go. That works. See, if I put it a little too close to me, I'd have traveled down on it. We've seen how that happened on previous editions of this show. Wow, it's all Sim City up here, man. It's kind of cool. Oh, well, fuck. That's not at all what I needed, is it? Oh, shit. Don't die! Oh, that hurt a lot. But I live. And really, that's all that matters. Gravel. I knew I'd find a use for you eventually. It's a stupid use, and anything could have been played in your place, especially all the sand I've been collecting of late, but... Take... Speaking of sand, let's get back to that, shall we? That is kind of a thing I need to be working on, isn't it? I cannot believe I can see that from this high up. Then again, given how big it is, as opposed to that single-dose pillar over there, I guess it's not too surprising that I would be able to see it from that high up. I can see that from there. What, you people thought you were done with navigation pillars? Oh, hell no. Oh, you fucking horse. one of you has my saddle, too. God only knows where that one ended up. Ah, that's where it ended up. Come here, you little shit. Can I shove your ass underground? Nope, because you're too fat. Give me that, fucking hay-eating machine. Gonna be a little shit, you can live in this damn bit of illness inside. Oh, no, you don't. Give me that. I'll collect you again in a minute. Little shit. Come here. As for you, damned horses. Fuck you. Anyway, nothing of note really happened this week. There was some D&D stuff. The podcast, as it seems right now, is off, which upsets me. I really was looking forward to that. But the guy who was going to run it doesn't think he can run it. He doesn't think he has the technicals for it, etc., etc. Insert heartbreaking excuse here. You know? And like I said, I'm real upset, because I was really looking forward to doing that podcast. And who knows, I might figure something out. I'm pretty clever. I might do something myself. Who knows? Oh, really? This whole time I've had two saddles? I've had three saddles? You know what? Let's take these saddles here for now. Just for now. And if they can't escape, I'll saddle them up for future stuffs. Did I never take the saddle off you? I must never have taken the saddle off you. Hi, Kisa. Cat's awake. He was sleeping. I guess I will saddle the other worthless horse, so that if it escapes and I find it, I can wreak my vengeance upon it. Probably with an axe. It's not mince words here. These horses are pissing me off. You stay in there. Oh, I hate how this ends up making everything look. Well, them's the breaks. It's been raining a bit lately, so I haven't really been able to go swimming, because as those of you who are familiar with pools know, rain tends to make the water cooler. and longtime viewers will know that I hate the cold in all its forms. Probably a side effect of growing up in Florida. I don't know. But, whatever the reason, it's my reason, and I haven't been swimming much because of it. Is this sand kind of sand? Yeah, that's plenty of sand kind of sand. I haven't recorded much of anything. I think the last time I spoke to everyone, I had already finished Season 2 with Sammy. But, like I said, I think that might very well have been the last time I spoke to anyone, so I might not have gotten anything done. Actually, I don't think so. Well, either way, I finished Season 2 with Sammy. We've been playing a little bit of Cards Against Humanity, but no recordings have happened. My prize kits for Star Trek have actually arrived. And we were going to have a tournament today, but as I was telling the one who's our driver half the time about the tournament format, she's like, oh, well, I can't make it because I've got finals this week. I'm like, okay, well, put it off then. Which was good, because I did have some money. I had enough money to spare if I could come up with some extra. But I'd rather just wait till next month when I have actual money from my check and use what little money I have left for various food things, you know? Because I like food. Food's yummy. Anyway, again, not a lot to go on this week. I haven't really been doing a whole lot. I'm pissed at Star Trek Online. I can't get it to work. There's some error thing it keeps coming up with, and I'm saying it's on their end because literally last week the game was working fine. You know, it's only since they went up to this next upgrade, one of their patches did something that caused my computer to hate it. I'm going to try and write into their technical people and tell them, hey, deal with this, because it's kind of stupid. As far as I know, my roommate has not gotten his birth certificate in yet, so no ID yet, so he doesn't have his job yet, but, well, we'll see. We'll see what can be made of this. Next month is going to absolutely suck until he gets his check, though. Gonna financially just wreck us until he gets paid. But once he does, all will be well. There's so many of these shovels. I did find out something just offhand, thanks to crack.com, that made me smile. Apparently, I've heard a little bit about it. There's a Daredevil series that's on Netflix that's getting kind of popular. And because it's popular, they have signed an Iron Fist, a Jessica Jones, a Defenders, and most importantly, a Luke Cage series. And I love me some Luke Cage. He is one of my favorite Avengers characters. And for those of you who don't follow comics very well, you're going to wonder, well, who the heck is he? When was he in the Avengers? He was in the New Avengers, after the real Avengers, as most people would call them, disbanded in the light of Avengers Disassembled. For a while, there were no Avengers, and then an incident occurred on one of the many, many supervillain prisons. This one was called The Raft, where a bunch of supervillains escaped. And all the heroes who happened to be on hand at the time were summoned into action. Daredevil was there as Matt Murdock. I think Luke Cage was there as an escort for somebody. The Sentry was kind of in a cell. Spider-Man made his way there somehow. Iron Man was there for reasons, Cap, etc., you know. But later on they added Wolverine and the New Avengers. I love the New Avengers. They're probably my favorite incarnation of the Avengers. And there have been a lot of different kinds of Avengers. Avengers, West Coast Avengers, Young Avengers, New Avengers, Mighty Avengers, Secret Avengers, just Avengers of every freaking flavor. I mean, chances are there's an Avengers group that'll suit your taste. Kind of like the Justice League, Justice League, Justice League International, Justice League of America, Justice League Europe, Justice League Antarctica. No. And apparently there's that new Avengers movie that I'm going to have to watch. I say that like it's a chore, but it's going to be kind of a pain to get flip it into my schedule, you know? But yeah, I'm excited. Saturday, food money comes in. I can go get some food, give me some damn eats. When my roommate gets a check, we're going to get a new microwave because I'm sick of not having one. Our current microwave is basically a glorified nightlight, you know? Or an oversized kitchen timer, take your pick. And I'm sick of all my food having to come from the stove. I mean, I'm used to my food starting on the stove, but not ending there, too. Unless I eat it all in one sitting, which is known to happen with a lot of foods, macaroni and tuna in particular. And eggs. Eggs don't really reheat much, because they don't last long enough to be reheated. And to buy a lot of corn, too. I like me some corn. One moment. Yeah, there's a lot. Well, there's not a lot going on, but there's things going on. No HeroClix tournament to report today, because I skipped it. Because for whatever reason, the judge decided to schedule the draft, and I told him, you know, it wasn't a good week. He's like, well, no week good for you. I'm like, no, next week would have been perfect for me, because I'd have gotten paid, I'd have been able to pay for my own boosters. And everybody got all sorts of fun Avengers figures for showing up, you know, and I didn't go, because I didn't want to not get everything that was entitled to me, that was due to me. He's like, well, I'm not going to loan you anything. I'm like, then I'm not going. My other friend couldn't loan it to me either, and I didn't want to go anyway, because I've really not been feeling HeroClix lately. I love the game, but I'm not feeling it. I don't know if it's just me getting ready to quit. Sorry, apparently they decide to keep knocking when I say I'm recording. But I don't know if I'm just falling out of the game, or I'm just not in the mood for it, or what. Because sometimes I'm not in the mood for clicks. And I keep telling the judge that, and he's like, well, why aren't you playing? Because I don't fucking want to play. I'm not enjoying the game anymore. And he's talking about, well, you always talk about how I'm a pessimist, and you're a pessimist about your game. I'm like, I'm not a pessimist about the game. I'm not having fun with it, so I don't want to go play it. That's the thing about a hobby. When you're not having fun with your hobby, you put the hobby away. And I do that with all my hobbies, and he just is so butthurt that I'm not having fun with his hobby right now because I have other ones. The funny thing was, he kept telling me that I need to start cutting stuff out so that my finances will balance out, and when I cut out HeroClix, it gets all butthurt. I'm like, I told you, I cut out HeroClix. I'm not cutting out D&D, because D&D amounts to $20 to $25 a month. You know? Stupid to cut out the one that's not costing me much. HeroClix, on the other hand, is costing me a small fortune. I told him, I'm like, you realize that if HeroClix only had 3 or 4 sets a year like they're supposed to, that I wouldn't owe you any money at all? He's like, well, yeah. I'm like, yeah, there's a reason for that. The game's too expensive for someone on disability to keep up with. It never used to be. Matter of fact, back in the old days when I was a judge during the set, like Captain America and Superman and all that, back when the sets were reasonable, if I had the kind of money then that I have now, which is just me getting most of my check minus some bills, I'd have been able to keep up with HeroClix effortlessly, a case, a set, period. Because they used to release them on a regular and yet reasonable basis. Where they would say, oh, we'll have this one, and then 3 months later we'll have this one, and this one, and this one. And we're 4 months in, and we're 3 sets deep. I'm counting Flash, because Flash was part January, part December, I think. We've had Trinity War, we have this set, we've got a new Avengers set coming up. And it's too much. It's too much. I just can't do it. I wish I could, but I can't. I don't have the kind of resources that anyone else has. And my friend said, you know, my wife told me, well, why don't you quit? He's like, well, I don't want to lose these guys as my friends. My immediate response is that is to then come visit me. Come hang out. Come over here or go or bring me up there. I'll hang out with you. If you don't want to drive, we have a dozen different games on the PlayStation that we can play over the internet that I will be happy to pop in this system. Get my Bluetooth on and play with you. And if you don't want to do that, there are all sorts of computer games like, say, Baldur's Gate that I had him buy that he won't fucking play. Or other MMOs that we could play together. I told him there's all sorts of options, so don't give me that crap. You know? He's like, well, I don't want to drive all the way down there. I'm like, then get used to the fact that you don't have anyone over. Because none of us are going to move up there, and you don't seem inclined to move where we are. So, I just told him, I'm like, look, if you want to hang out, then come hang out. Because the difference between me and him is he has the means to get here. Well, technically, I have the means to get there, but it basically involves leaving in the middle of the night, getting there in the morning, and then just... Or leaving in the morning and getting there at night, and we'll just hang out the following day when I wake up. You know, as opposed to him, who can drive for 45 minutes and hang out for several hours. And I told him, because he was talking about the Star Trek game, I told him that if he wants to play, he needs to start showing up early because I am so, so stupidly sick of him getting there 2 or 3 hours late and us having no real tournament. We have one giant battle royale match, or we each have one match and then just throw our hands in the air as to who win, you know? So that the HeroClix players can play, and it's really pissing me off, and that's also making me dislike HeroClix, that I have to give up the game that I actually wanted to play that day for that game that I don't want to play. I think what I'm going to start doing is, like, getting bus fare or something. Because I can set aside bus fare and just take bus fare up there and get my friend some kind of bus fare somehow. I'm not sure how yet. But get him some bus fare and we'll just go up there for Star Trek. And if the other guy isn't there, we just play without him and he can get a buy round. You know? And he'll either learn to wake up on time... Or he won't. Plus, if I have bus fare, that way, if I don't want to stay for HeroClix, I don't have to. I can just go home. And he's asked me, well, why do you not like Clix? I'm like, okay, number one, I do have other things I do during the week. I know he's under the impression that I have absolutely no life and nothing I do. But, I mean, just all the D&D stuff I've got to prep for at any given time is wearing me out. Especially since I have to bike, or in some cases, walk there. Which takes a lot more energy than you think. Wait, what? Is that a... Oh, dear. Did I just find a village? Did I finally find a village? With a pyramid, for some reason. I didn't know villagers built pyramids, but okay. Well then, let's do this. I kind of feel they've taken the piss out of me a little bit. If you hadn't guessed, I was building a pyramid, then this frickin' game comes out and builds one for me. I wonder why there are no villagers here. Maybe it's because it's not a real village. Could also be because I'm on safe mode, basically. He you know, seeing that little villager church symbol thing makes me wonder, just out of curiosity. I mean, I know they're familiar with the whole crucifixion thing with Jesus, but I wonder if Christians ever stop to think that they're basically, their holy symbol is an execution device. Does that ever occur to them at any point in their day, just, wow, this is like Jesus' electric chair? It's just weird shit that I think about sometimes. But yeah, going back to what I was saying about the judge, I told him, I'm like, look, half the time, we don't have the numbers we used to have, where we have like 7 or 8 people show up. It's generally me, Anubis, sometimes Skinner, he's been coming a lot more lately, our driver, himself, his roommate, and the new guy. You know? We don't have the we're not pulling the numbers we once pulled. That's what I'm getting at here. So, basically, I could have all of these tournaments in my living room. Like, yeah, we wouldn't get a prize. I'm like, number one, these prizes suck. Number two, I don't win them anyway, so what's the difference? And number three, at least if I'm at home, I have the option to do something else. Because he doesn't understand, it's not even 3 hours out of my day, because I spend a lot of that day waiting on him. And then when he gets here, he drives really slow. So it takes him about as long to get somewhere as it takes me to get on the bus. I know, because I timed it once. And then he drags his ass, setting up the rounds. He likes to socialize instead of just getting down to business and getting the thing started so we can get on with the thing we came there for. And then between rounds, he'll do stuff, or he'll play so he won't get the scores done, you know. And then he'll socialize some more between rounds. Maybe one of the rounds will end and he'll go and get a soda real quick or something. Though usually that's us getting the sodas and not him. But sometimes it's him. And then after it all, it's like, okay, so who wants to go to dinner? No, I don't want to go to dinner. I'm broke and I want to go home. I wanted to go home earlier, you know? Like last time, because he wasn't there for Star Trek, we had our Star Trek tournament, and it was a Battle Royale. Well, Battle Royales are not quick things. So, we had to have a winner, so we know who won. So it had to play out in its entirety, and it ended up playing very late. We ended up cutting into about an hour of HeroClix time. And because of that, when he did start HeroClix, and again, he operates on a really warped sense of time, once we finally started HeroClix, we ran so late that they delayed closing the store for an hour so we could finish our tournament. And then we went to dinner. Long story short, I got home at about 10:30, 11 o'clock. When, back in the old days, we used to get home at 6:30, 7 o'clock. You know, and that included dinner. So, my enthusiasm for HeroClix has waned because HeroClix is becoming a chore. The prizes suck, I can't afford the sets. The last set, Trinity War, I have 2 boosters worth. I own 9 figures from Trinity War because I gave him one to clear $15 a debt. Out of an entire set, I have 9 figures to show for it. For the record, those sets tend to be anywhere from 60 to 70 figures. I have 9. And I only have those because, as he would say, I insisted on being a baby and not going unless someone would loan me the money to buy my own boosters. I almost didn't have those, you know? And we've already come out with a mini set that I have nothing for. And another set coming out that I'm probably not going to have anything for either. You know, and it upsets me. Because I've managed to, ever since I came back, ever since Crisis, I have managed to stay current on figures. I may not have everything, but I tend to have at least a common, uncommon, and rare, a CUR set of everything I play. And I can't do that anymore, and it really bothers me. And I feel like I've fallen so far behind that I can't possibly keep up. And on top of that, WizKids used to release two figures every year for Gen Con, for big conventions. And they were convention exclusive, and they'd have one for Marvel and one for DC, and now it's just going crazy. Like when the utility belt came out, oh, we've got like 10 special items for the utility belt, and they cost like $50 each. You buy them on eBay, or no, it was like $20 or $25 each on eBay. And then the constructs came out, and those were like $100 each until they re-released those. And now there's like, oh, well, here's five figures in a Colossal for this set, and five figures in a Colossal for this set. And I can't keep up. And I'm tired of trying. I basically said, here's the deal. If WizKids cools their fucking jets down, you know, if they cool it down, if they relax, if they start releasing these on a reasonable schedule, then I'll stay. But not only have they not done that, they've turned around and given me a game that does release on a really reasonable schedule. They've given me Star Trek. And through Star Trek, I'm able to keep up with the damn game. So why would I play HeroClix when Star Trek is much less of a pain in the ass for me? I'm able to enjoy it. I have fun with it. And just, it's completely different for me. It's not the headache that Clix has become, and it hurts me to say that Clix is a headache, but Clix is a fucking headache. I wish it weren't, but it is, and that's just the way it is. And because of being broke, and kits not arriving, and people not showing up, we haven't had Star Trek in 2 weeks either. But hey, that means that my Tuesdays at least are freeing up. If I'd known I wasn't going, I'd have arranged for the cat to go to the vet today. Because it occurred to me, as we were trying to think of what a good day for the cat to go to the vet was, that all the times I'd pick him up, I'd already left for D&D on most of the days this week, except for the weekends. So, and I could have someone else pick him up, but I don't want to do that to my poor cat. He needs to be home with Daddy, especially since this is his first trip home from the vet in this new place. He's either going to come home groggy and full of drool and covered in it, or he's going to come home stoned to shit and not know where he is. And it sounds cute, and believe me, it actually is. It's very cute when your cat is high off his fucking mind. But it's also very scary for him. You know, he doesn't know what's going on. He'll sit out in the kitchen and cry at nothing. And I just bumped the camera because I'm a derp. Yeah, I just don't want him to have to come home by himself without Daddy here. I mean, he's my cat, it's my job to look after him, and I'm gonna do it. You know what, let's trim this down a bit. Rather than just filling out the whole thing like this, which, don't get me wrong, we're going to fill out the whole thing. But rather than just filling it out, let's do a row at a time. Like this. And just let it fill itself out. I mean, it's still going to take the same amount of sand, but I feel like I'm making progress when I do it this way. Yeah, I've got so many series I gotta get caught up on. Arrow, Flash, Star Wars Rebels, you know. Just hope my niece is back tomorrow before 6. Well, before 5, really. So that I don't have to walk to the store when I do my gaming. But if I do, then I do, and it wouldn't be the first time, and it probably won't be the last, at least until I get my own bike again. You know the ironic thing? Sand does not blend in as well as sandstone does. If I look down, I can clearly see steps in this sand. If I were to make this sandstone and I look down, you would not be able to tell. You wouldn't be able to tell if I was on a flat plane like this, or if I was on stairs like this. I know because I've done it. Oh, man. Watch some movies too. I need to watch some movies. Just don't know what I'm in the mood to watch. I have been playing a lot of Pokemon lately, except this time I've switched over from Pokemon Shuffle to Pokemon Rumble World, though don't think I've completely given up on Shuffle. I did, for example, catch the new Legendary that came out a couple days ago, Celebi. Caught it on my first try. And while not the most difficult Legendary and challenging one, I don't care. Sometimes you just want to catch the damn thing and get on with the next level. I'm still mad that I never got Keldeo, though. And I'm excessively angry that I've never caught Mega Gengar. Or beaten it. I've never even caught Gengar, much less the Mega Gengar. But yeah, like I told my friend, I think, with any luck, this will be next month, May, will be the last truly hard financial month while we're here. Because the roommate will have his job, and it'll take us a while to get caught up on the bills, but once we are, we'll be golden. We'll be set. Everything will be great. And I think this because if I don't think this, I'm gonna go crazy. Because we had an argument about that. Like, he, for example, the judge was talking to me, like, on my finances. Like, oh, you're doing it wrong. You're doing it wrong. What you need to do, because you're a nub and you don't want a house and you don't want a car, what you need to do is just not pay your credit card bills. I'm like, I'm not defaulting. I'm like, well, you're not gonna use credit anyway. I'm like, number one, I don't like to do stuff like that. And I told him, well, it's a slippery slope from let's not pay back the credit cards to, oh, well, let's not pay you back either. I'd rather spend that $200 on something else. Like, well, it's different when it's your friends. It's not, there's the difference between your friends and a heartless corporation. I'm like, I don't live in the conspiracy theory world that you do. It's like, well, they're trying to screw you out. I'm like, yeah, they probably are, but that doesn't mean I screw them back. That's not how I operate. He's like, I'm pessimistic because everyone's always screwed me over. I'm like, yeah, well, guess what? I haven't lived that life. I don't live a life just drowning in fucking pessimism. I actually happen to think life's pretty good. Because for me, it has been. He's like, well, yeah, you've always had a safety net. I'm like, no. My safety net is called being adaptive and being able to plan things. And not throwing away advantages and on stupid shit. Like, for example, defaulting on my credit card to save myself a couple dollars. You know? I told him that, the time may come very soon when I need that credit card for something, and I don't want to be an idiot. You're like, well, I'm going to save myself some money and not pay this. Yeah, well then, what am I going to do when I need it down the road? And of course, every one of my friends I've told this to is like, yeah, that's a really stupid thing to do, to default on your credit card for such a short-term gain. Or gain, rather. Especially the new guy is like, yeah, that doesn't just ruin you financially, it destroys your credit. And that is a nightmare to build up. What he also doesn't realize, the judge, is that I only spent, 8 years trying to get to the point where I could even get a credit card. Which involved getting credit, and I got it accidentally. Because I kept trying to find ways to get credit. And nothing worked, you know? And what finally did work... Oh good, you're both there. Maybe you'll stay there this time. What finally did work was going to Finger Hut and paying them. And just not missing any of my bills. You know? And without that credit card, moving would not have been difficult. It would have been impossible. I would have been able to do nothing. So yeah, that credit card kind of, you know, saved my ability to move. And he wonders why I don't just default on it. Can't imagine why. But yeah, I told him that this is going to sound bad, but this is coming from a purely pragmatic stance of I don't throw away advantages. Throwing aside, completely turning aside things like trust and friendship and things like that, the truly pragmatic, the absolute logical and pragmatic reason that I never fail to pay back my friends is because I don't want the situation to arise where I really need money. And everyone's like, yeah, you'll never pay me back. And then I screw myself. You know? I mean, I generally don't think of it in those terms. Because I do. I like my friends. I want my friends to trust me. And you know what? They do. Because I'm trustworthy to them. I don't let them down when they need me for something. And I told him I don't want to be in that situation. I'm like, do you know why I owe you like $200 or so? Because you've never had an issue getting me to pay you back. You know? And the other thing is, he wants me to immediately be financially independent. You know? He also wants me to go down to day labor for whatever reason. I told him, no, it's not my job to cover that particular bill. That's the roommate. You know? I've covered as much as I'm gonna cover out of other people's payments. And he's like, well, you're an idiot for relying on people. I'm like, no, I'm a human being who has roommates. That's the point to having a roommate. Is they cover half the bills, you cover half the bills, or in my case, they cover a third and I cover a third. And between the three of us, we're able to live in better conditions than any one of us could alone. For example, I would be living in an efficiency, my mother would be in a nursing home, and he would either be with his dad or with my niece, who would be with her sister. And that's the situation we'd all be in. Instead, we have our own place in a very, very nice location. I mean, we're not in the city or anything, but we have a little grocery store in the form of Big Lots right across the street from us. On the other corner across the street from it is a Circle K, which is open 24 hours. So a lot of times I'll go out at like 2 o'clock in the morning and go get a drink or something. Because sometimes they're open inside at late night, sometimes they're not, but they always have the window open. And then right behind us, we have a Walgreens, which is great when you need medication. They're not 24 hours, but hey, you can't have everything. Across the street from that is a McDonald's. We haven't really gone there much because we've been freaking broke. But the fact that there's a McDonald's, this is the closest I've ever been to any fast food place. I walk out my door, I turn right, I walk through the woods for like a minute. I cross the street, I'm at McDonald's. You know? Never in my life, in any place I've lived, have I been that close to a fast food place. And again, we don't go there often, but the option is always there. A short bike ride away, we have Walmart, and Publix, and Albertsons, and my bank. I don't use that one, because the only time I go to my bank usually is to get money out for the rent, and then I need an Amscot, and only my old bank is near one of those. But across the street, there's like a pizza place. Right behind my house, even closer than the Walgreens, is Domino's Pizza. You know, there's a cafe, there's a pub, there's all sorts of just eating places and all of that good stuff. Right here, right within a 5 to 6 minute walk of where I live. There's a FedEx place if I ever need anything FedEx. I mean, I literally couldn't have built a better location than this. If they just had my bank closer, and an Amscot within that plaza, this would be the perfect location. I never need to leave. Well, in a movie theater. You know? And speaking of banks, my mother's bank is right by the house. It's about as close as the Big Lots is. Just in the other direction. So because I have a roommate and I don't insist on being financially independent, I'm able to afford a nice place in a nice location. And even he says, yeah, he's got a nice place there. But for some reason, it irks him that I need a roommate to afford this. He's like, well, yeah, I have roommates, but I can pay the bills myself. If they all moved out tomorrow, nothing would change at my house. And I'm thinking, yeah, stuff would change. You wouldn't be able to afford anything you like. Everything would come out of your pocket, and you'd move out of that place in a fucking month. But again, he also doesn't understand the fact that financial independence is not a one-step process. And I've had that argument with him, too. Ironically, I shouldn't be having any of these arguments with him because I told him, my finances are none of your business. And when he hears me say, shut up, my finances aren't your business, he hears, oh, please tell me more of your financial wisdom. Please tell me how I too could commit credit card fraud and default on my credit cards and do this and do that and do that and somehow not end up in jail. Because when I ended up owing U-Haul $200, like, oh, you should immediately call your credit card company and tell them to cancel that it was a mistake, someone stole your card, you lost your card. I'm like, no. For one thing, I was there in person, and they required my ID, which they matched to my credit card, so they know it's me. For another thing, I called my bank directly, so they know it's me. And for another thing, I'm not a scumbag, so no. It just... no. But yeah, it upsets him that even though I have a phone, cable, internet, power, and a house in, well, apartment, but I call it a house because it's where I live. A home in my name. I need other people to pay for it with me. Not that they're paying for it instead of me. They're paying for it with me. Because of that, I'm a loser. I'm like, really? Because this is literally what every single one of my friends did, with one exception. and even he wasn't much of an exception. He moved out and he had roommates here and there, but for the most part he had the place himself, because they would move out or they'd get into fights or whatever. But pretty much all of my friends started off with a roommate, just like I did. And I told him, dude, I'm going from living in a trailer with my mother to living in an apartment and my mother living with me, and everything's in my name. How is that not a step towards independence? Apparently, the first step towards moving out on your own is get a mansion that you pay for. And anything else is a step backwards. And he's apparently the only person who thinks that way. I'm going to tell you a little secret right now. Not one person I've ever known who lived by themselves had a nice place. The friend I mentioned earlier, half the time he was only able to keep the place because he'd get money from his grandmother or his parents. So it was basically like having a roommate. And when I say not a nice place, I'm not saying it was, I mean, it was messy, but not in a way that I ever felt, oh God, I feel diseased being here, you know? But it's a fact that unless you're some kind of neat freak, as soon as you live alone, your place doesn't get as clean as it needs to be, you know? I mean, my place isn't as clean as it needs to be now. I need to take one of these days and just turn that kitchen upside down. You know, because it's a bit of a mess. And it doesn't need to be. But, again, because I have roommates, I have a nice place. I've got a two-bedroom, two-bathroom place in a neighborhood with two pools, neighbors that have never given us a problem. Matter of fact, we kind of have an extra dog because of one of the neighbors. It's kind of a community dog, really. A location that I'm just thrilled to death with. And it's even close, at least by bike ride, to everything I used to live by. You know? I can, by bike, within a half an hour, get to any place I used to go to. So, yeah. But I keep telling him, and he doesn't understand, I tend to be a private person. Which is really funny being said on the show where I tell the entire internet what's going on with my life. But as I explained to my other friend, Jay, I told him, and he agreed. I'm like, here's the thing. I only tell you guys what I want you to know. There's nobody coming in the comments section telling me, no, you have to tell me this right now. Because I'll tell you, no. You know, that's exactly what I'll say. None of you viewers, whether you're a first-time viewer or someone who's seen every episode of everything I've ever done, none of you has any say over what I say here. I control the information flowing out completely. And if I happen to say something I shouldn't have said, I can always edit that out. You know? And it's the same way with my friends. If I want you to know something, you'll know it. But the majority of my life is my business. And I do share a lot of that with my friends. You know? But this particular friend, the judge, tends to, as I put it, muscle his way into stuff he's not cleared to know. Like, he's constantly trying to set me up with someone. I'm not going to say who. And I tell him, first of all, I think, well, why don't you believe me? I'm like, because you're exactly the kind of person who just gets off on mayhem. Who would love to see me in this situation just to get shot down, just so you can get a laugh out of it. He's like, well, I wouldn't do that. I'm like, I have only your word and the words of people who would be equally amused by this to go on. So forgive me if I'm not very trusting. And I keep telling him, number one, I'm very, very private about that stuff. Because I mentioned during the conversation, one of my exes came up, and he's like, well, how come I never hear about her? I'm like, because I don't talk about her. Because, number one, it wasn't exactly a very high point in my life. And number two, that's my private life, and I keep that to myself. And I told him the same thing about my finances is that if I tell you shut up about it, you have no right to butt in about it because it's none of your business. Unless you're my tax person or my accountant or whatever, and he's not, he has no say in my finances as long as I pay him back what I owe him. And I told him, as soon as I start getting enough money to have money, he'll get paid back, and he knows that's the case. The only reason I haven't been paying him back before this is because a lot of times when it's a choice between paying him back or doing tournament, he's like, oh, do the tournament, I can wait, I'm not hurting for money right now. Otherwise, he'd have been paid back by now. And I pointed that out to him, too. And I've told him that every other one of my friends, if I told them to shut up about it, they would have. He's like, well, that's because they're not your real friends. I'm telling you the hard truth you don't want to know. I'm like, no, you're being an ass and butting in and interfering with things that aren't your concern. Believe it or not, I have things handled. I have had things handled. And it just drives me nuts that he doesn't know what no means. He doesn't realize that when I tell him the subject is closed, that means you're not going to get anything more out of me. And I even tell him, quit wasting your breath trying to give me financial advice. I'm not listening, and I'm not going to listen. Because you're giving me advice that's going to get me arrested. It's like, no, I'm not. That's stupid. Who told you that? Everyone. Everyone told me that. I told them what you told me, and they're like, yeah, that's a felony. Or that's a misdemeanor. Or that's a crime. Or you're going to go to jail for that. You know? And so far, I'm one of my very few friends who's never been arrested for anything, and I'd like to keep it that way. I also don't have bad credit. I'd like to keep it that way. You know? I don't have great credit, but I don't have bad credit either. But the thing that started the financial argument, and I'm not going to go into specifics, but basically, the way I'm managing my finances, he is convinced that I owe a lot more money than I do. And when I've told him that that's not the case at all, he's like, well, then you don't understand how this works. And I'm thinking, no, you don't understand how this works. I watch my financial records just fanatically, because it's a thing. When you're poor, you keep track of every penny you own. Because that penny can mean the difference between having something and not having something. I mean, that could be the difference between having a pizza and having ramen that day, you know? Speaking of which, I need to eat today. It just occurred to me that I haven't eaten today. I haven't eaten food. Don't think, oh no, Kyrix is starving. No. What it is I've had a bag of Cheetos next to me that I bought last night. And I just had it curled up, because I don't have a bed right now. Partly because I haven't had a chance to get a new one since we moved. The old one was crap. And partly because, for now at least, the love seat recliner is working just fine. I kind of like it better, to be honest. Because it's about as comfortable as a bed. It could be more comfortable, but it's not bad. And because it's in two pieces, I kind of have a functional table, because I, for some reason, don't roll over onto that side of the thing, so I can put stuff there, like my laptop, or books, or whatever. Or in this case, a rolled up bag of Cheetos. So that bag of Cheetos, every time I've been hungry, I just reach over and eat some Cheetos, and then I'm good. And that's why I haven't eaten today, because I haven't done anything, except sleep, because I'm still getting over a cold. So, that bag of Cheetos has been enough to keep me going all day. And I really need to eat soon. Also, that timer's about to go. any second now. There it is. But I'm gonna finish these up and then I'll see ya. But yeah, I just keep telling him, don't worry about my finances. Unless I'm bankrupt, I'm doing fine. I'm no better or worse off than anyone else in my situation. Actually, I'm probably better off than most people in my situation. Yeah, like I said, a couple cents can be the difference between having a good meal and having to settle for something. Or having something and having nothing, you know, so. Small wonder I keep a smart eye on my finances at all times. I couldn't tell you right now exactly what I have, but I know I've got about, let's say, $6 in the bank, and about $1.50 on my credit card, and let's say about $2.50 sitting on my nightstand. Doesn't add up to much, but that's right now all the money I have. And I know I said I account for everything, but that's right before, if I were to go right now to try and go buy something from Circle K, which I'm not, but I'm going to in about an hour when the normal night girl usually opens. But if I were going to do that, what I would first do is check my bank account and make sure how much I have in case I want to buy something else, so that I don't overspend. And I do that without exception every time I make any kind of purchase that isn't in cash. Because I have one time overdrafted. Well, technically three times. The one of them didn't count as an overdraft because of my bank settings. But I've overdrafted once before I realized what that was. Because I always understood it that when you try and make a purchase with a debit card that you can't, it just gets declined. Turns out, no, it just goes in and then you overdraft. And then they pull out like $40, and then you do it again, and you get the idea. So, ever since that happened, I've made damn sure that that will never happen again. Anyway, I'm sorry that this was such a pessimistic episode. I hate delivering those. But I'll see you next time with maybe better news? I'm Kyrix, and this has been This Week in Kyrix, and thank you so much for watching. And I will see you next time. Bye-bye.